Friends, today in this video I am going to discuss about a thought-provoking judgment made by Supreme Court. Supreme Court says NCLT has no jurisdiction on a civil matter and no parallel proceeding is allowed in the NCLT on inheritance matters. So inheritance of shares or property is a civil case and NCLT or NCLAT do not have any authority or jurisdiction to try over this. Supreme Court set aside the orders of both NCLT and NCLAT in the case of oppression and mismanagement in Aruna Oswal versus Pankaj Oswal. Earlier, I have issued a video on the order made by NCLT and the NCLAT allowing the petition of Pankaj Oswal, who holds just 0.037% of shares in the company, alleging oppression and mismanagement and against the nominee of his father's shares by Aruna Oswal, his mother. However, in an appeal by Aruna Oswal, Supreme Court held that NCLT and NCLAT do not have any authority to decide about civil matters by observing that inheritance of shares is a civil matter and cannot be decided by the company tribunals. The Cuffax Court, Supreme Court, has set as precedent that will do away with the parallel proceedings in future disputes in NCLT and NCLAT. Supreme Court decided eminently and authoritatively a dual legal battle as to inheritance of shares involving the family members of an industrial house in the matter of Aruna Oswal versus Pankaj Oswal and others, Civil Appeal 9340 of 2019, decided on July 6, 2020, by Supreme Court. The latest judgment of the Supreme Court will bring clarity to the corporate sector while dealing with such disputes. The case is the outcome of a family tussle. The patriarch, during his lifetime, made a nomination in the prescribed manner in favor of his wife in respect of shares amounting to 39.88% in Oswal Agro Mills Limited. The disgruntled son, respondent one, filed a partition suit in the High Court, claiming entitlement to 1/4 of the estate of the father, including 1/4 of the shares inherited by his mother from his father in this said company, and the similarly 1/4 of the shares out of the 11% of another company as inherited by mother from his father. The High Court passed an interim order to maintain status quo concerning shares and other immovable property. It is to be noted that as on date of the interim order, the shares stood registered in the name of his mother, who construes to be the owner owning the share. While the suit was pending, Respondent 1 also moved the National Company Law Tribunal alleging oppression and mismanagement under the provisions of the Companies Act 2013 without even owning a threshold limit of 10% of the shares in the company as the minimum requirement. His mother filed an application before NCLT challenging the maintainability of the oppression and mismanagement petition on various grounds, including that she was the absolute owner of the shares as per the provision of the Companies Act 2013. Essence, it was the principal contention of the mother that the main dispute raised as to inheritance of the deceased father's estate was a civil dispute and could not be said to be an act of oppression and mismanagement, and parallel proceedings on the same issue were not appropriate. However, curiously, the NCLT directed the filing of reply to the petition without deciding the question of maintainability. This was challenged before the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, which in turn directed the NCLT to decide the question of maintainability of the petition. The NCLT thereafter dismissed the challenge to the maintainability and held the son, being the legal owner or heir, was entitled to 1/4 of the shares. Thereby, the matter eventually reached the Supreme Court of India. Right to vest. According to Section 72 of the Companies Act 2003, every holder of the security has a right to nominate any person to whom his security shall vest in the event of the death. Section 72(3) overrides anything contained in any other law, in force, or any disposition, whether testamentary or otherwise. Nomination is validly made in the prescribed manner. it purports to confer on any person the right of vest the securities of the company, and all the rights and the securities shall vest in the nominee unless the nomination is varied or cancelled in the prescribed manner. Prima facie, once shares vest in the nominee, he becomes absolute owner of the securities on the strength of the nomination and can participate in the company meetings. The court observed that there was no doubt in the absence of nomination, the legal representative cannot be denied the right to maintain a petition regarding the oppression and mismanagement. In this case, however, the nomination has been made, Supreme Court held, and the nominee is registered as the holder of the shares. What is the effect of the same is to be decided by the civil court in the pending civil suit. This is the matter which has to be decided by a civil court, and the right of the nominees would depend upon what is provided statutorily. The decision in the civil suit would be binding between the parties of the question of the right, title and interest, and it is the civil court domain to determine in a suit for partition. Dispute as to inheritance of shares is eminently a civil dispute and cannot be said to be a dispute as regards to oppression and mismanagement so as to attract company law jurisdiction by company law tribunal. Thus, the Supreme Court, after weighing a catena of case cited at the bar, held that respondent has nothing to do with the affairs of the company and he was not a registered owner of the shares. He did not represent the body of shareholders holding requisite percentage of shares, that is 10% in the company, necessary in order to maintain the petition for oppression and mismanagement. The question of right, title and interest is essentially an adjudication of civil rights between the parties as to the effect of nomination. The decision taken in a civil suit will govern the rights of the parties. It would not be appropriate to entertain parallel proceedings in civil court as well as in NCLT. Hence, the Supreme Court directed dropping of proceedings before the NCLT and NCLAT regarding the oppression and mismanagement by setting aside the orders of the both the NCLT and the NCLAT. Friends, what we learn from this case, NCLT or NCLAT cannot entertain civil disputes. Waiving 10% of total voting power cannot be overlooked by NCLT, where a proper nomination has been made and the ownership of share S is yet to be decided by the civil court. No parallel proceedings will be entertained both in civil court and NCLT on the same matter. Inheritance of shares is eminently a civil dispute and cannot be said to be the dispute as regards to oppression and mismanagement so as to attract the company law jurisdiction. Section 72, subsection 3 of the Companies Act 2013 overrides anything contained in any other law in force or any disposition, whether testamentary or otherwise. Here, Mr. Oswald did not write any will, and hence the inheritance issue is being raised by the legal heirs against their own mother. Friends, if you like this video, I request you to subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, Practicing Companies.